BBC 4 from 1981. Dame Janet Baker in concert at the Queen's Hall in Edinburgh.
Good evening and welcome to this special concert from the Queen's Hall in Edinburgh, given by the Scottish Chamber Orchestra under their principal guest conductor, Raymond Leppard. The soloist is one of the world's great singers, Dame Janet Baker. She sings two dramatic works for voice and orchestra, Mendelssohn's concert aria, Infelice, and Handel's dramatic solo cantata, Lucrezia. In 1832, when he was only 23, Mendelssohn was commissioned by the London Philharmonic Society to write a symphony, an overture, and a vocal piece. The symphony was the Italian. It's thought that the overture was the Hebrides, and the last of the three to be written, the vocal piece, was his only concert aria, Infelice, Unhappy One, completed in 1834. The theme is a familiar one, a woman abandoned by her lover, but whose bitter feelings vie with her continued love for him. In the opening recitative, she rages against him. In the following andante part, she remembers their days of happiness together, while in the impassioned final allegro, she realizes the futility of such memories. And here now is Dame Janet Baker with the conductor, Raymond Leppard.
Thank you.
In that concert aria, it could be said that Mendelssohn was looking over his shoulder, musically speaking, to the Baroque period. And in tonight's programme, the two other works are from that period. They're both by Handel. And first, the Scottish Chamber Orchestra, leader John Tunnell, play the overture to the spectacular opera Alcina. In all, Handel wrote five operas on subjects involving magic or sorcery. Two of them, Alcina and Orlando, were both derived from incidents in the greatest of the Italian romantic epic poems, Ariosto's Orlando Furioso, and they're among Handel's finest dramatic works. Indeed, Alcina is a sort of fairy tale, full of wonderful scenic effects and enchanting ballets. The overture, which we're going to hear, is in four sections. The first two are the stately rhythm and fast fugal parts expected in an overture of Handel's time. The remaining two are short dance movements, part of the dance music included by Handel for the French ballerina Marie Salle, whom he greatly admired. They are a charming musette with the Scotch snap rhythm and a courtly minuet. And here is Raymond Lepard to conduct the overture to Handel's opera, Alcina.
Thank you.
Handel's overture Alcina, played by the Scottish Chamber Orchestra, conducted by Raymond Lapham. Classical legends provided a large proportion of the 18th century's operatic plots, and Handel often turned for inspiration to the same mythological sources when he wanted to write a dramatic solo cantata not intended for the stage. Lucrezia is the most elaborate of many solo cantatas composed by Handel in his early 20s during a stay in Italy. It's based on the story of Lucretia, the beautiful wife of the commander of the Roman army in the 6th century BC, who is raped and deserted by Tarquinius and kills herself to save her honor. In the cantata, Handel portrays Lucretia's state of mind between her violation by Tarquin and her suicide. It begins with a recitative and aria in which Lucrezia calls on the gods to destroy Tarquin. Spurned by them, she turns to the spirits of hell to avenge her, to no avail. And finally, in shame and despair, she bids farewell to her father, her husband, and to Rome, and kills herself. But even as the knife turns, she swears to take revenge in hell, cruel and unrelenting. Here now are Dame Janet Baker and Raymond Leppard, who has orchestrated this work, returning to the platform. Handel's dramatic solo cantata, Lucrezia. Dame Janet Baker returning to the platform to acknowledge the tremendous reception here tonight for her performance of Handel's solo cantata, Lucrezia. And Dame Janet comes back again, this time with the principal guest conductor of the Scottish Chamber Orchestra, that very distinguished musician, Raymond Leppard. And so from this memorable evening in the Queen's Hall here in Edinburgh, good night.